the idea of me making fitness content just kind of makes me want to throw up in my mouth just a little bit. And it's not because I don't like fitness content. I watch a ton of it, quite frankly. But though I have lost a couple pounds over the last year or so, I still got a ton of chub in this old brain of mine. And just the idea of me making fitness content kind of makes me just resent myself in the same way that I really wasn't crazy about fitness content, you know, a year to a year and a half ago. That being said, especially after shows, a lot of the conversation I've had with y'all turns to just general weight loss and health. And I thought it would be cool to make a video just kind of outlining some of the mindset changes that allowed me to make health and fitness a part of my life in a very sustainable and manageable way. I feel a little bit lame saying things like my fitness journey, but fitness for me started in Nashville. And my friends, shout outs to Brad and Conrad, started bringing me to yoga before sessions.
You're probably wondering what I'm doing in this weird position.
This particular yoga studio was pretty serious and I got absolutely punished. I kind of just felt like a beached whale covered in canola oil, and probably I wasn't even sweating sweat. It might have actually been canola oil. And the yoga instructor was loud, she was brash, and she was like snapping her fingers a lot and was just really demanding. It was extremely difficult. She kind of had this like shitty Princess Leia vibes, and I felt like subservient Jabba the Hutt. Like our roles were reversed and I was Princess Leia's prisoner. But apparently I really liked it. I noticed after the session, I just had this overwhelming feeling of well-being. There was mental clarity. I just had more energy. And again, this was after me just getting absolutely destroyed in this yoga class. And that feeling lasted for the rest of the day. There are many pleasures in this world. And sometimes you just need a little bit of curiosity and maybe just an openness to new experiences to unlock a lot of those pleasures. Now, I'm not saying that yoga is what you should just go out and do right now. It turns out that there's like a million different ways to get your heart rate up.
The water, I sink like a fucking rock.
Or to get some resistance training going on. Some of those ways are really, really fun.
All right, how do you feel?
I feel awful.
Maybe it's hiking or paddleboarding or whatever. My advice is to experiment, try new things, and when you find a particular activity that brings you joy, double down on it and focus on the way that it makes you feel. I can slam an entire box of donuts, and I will do it because it makes me feel a particular way. It makes me feel good. I go out for a run for the very same reason. It makes me feel good.
Yeah.
Improved health and weight loss or muscle growth, whatever, those are all byproducts of you just having a good time. Now, maybe I'm just speaking for myself, but I know in the past, the few times that I went into a gym, it was because I wanted to look super sexy while I was only wearing socks, like those long white ones that aren't necessarily 100% white. But was I really wanting to look sexy for myself? No, I was worried about how other people perceived me. But unfortunately, it's just not all that sustainable. So I would encourage you to not worry about looking sexy in socks. Try not to focus so much on losing weight, what the scale says, and just go because you want to have a good time.
Basically, if it doesn't fit, then you're not messing up.
Shit.
All right, this leads us to tip number two, start small. I think people have a tendency to go really hard when they first set their minds that they're gonna lose weight. Like they have some nebulous weight loss goal, or maybe they got like parent-teacher conferences coming up and for some reason they wanna lose weight for that. But anyways, they hit the gym, they go really hard, they're sweating, they're really sore, they're not having all that much fun, and there's this stressful goal off in the distance that they're trying to reach. Anyways, the goal period comes around, you go to parent-teacher conferences, yeah, maybe you lost a couple pounds, and then as soon as that's over, you just go back to the same exact lifestyle that you were living before. Rather than going super hard, rather than focusing on some goal off in the distance, focus on just making very small changes. Small changes are much easier to implement in the long run. And these small changes allow you to start developing habits which turn small changes into big lifestyle changes, things that can improve the rest of your life. When I first discovered that running could be fun, I went really, really hard. I ended up just getting hurt a whole bunch.
Oh, my knees fucking killing me.
I was even in a boot for a month. I think some of you probably saw me playing shows, sitting down, wearing a fucking boot. It was kind of fun for like 3 days, and then it got old really quickly, and it caused a big break in my momentum, which could have very well spelled the end of fitness for me. And quite frankly, getting started after being injury-free was really, really difficult. But in the beginning, make the priority consistency. And you can achieve consistency by being moderate in your approach, by not going all out. Maybe it's just walking for 15 minutes every other day, or going to the gym twice a week, and then slowly start to build upon it. Not only will it reduce your risk of injury, but it just increases the likelihood of these activities becoming habitual.
Our brains are pretty damn good at rewarding us for things that benefit our survival,
to try to encourage us to continue doing that.
I like to think of my brain being inhabited by a bunch of machine elves who, when I do something that may increase the likelihood of me like outrunning a lion or making me a more attractive partner overall, that the machine elves are like, let's reward him. He gets his cookie for the day.
Anyways, if you do something consistently, the chances of it becoming habitual, the chances of it becoming an everyday part of your life where you don't even think about it, or even more, you desire to do it, those chances just become far greater. And on the subject of goals, goals are great. And if they work for you, keep it up. But I'd almost encourage you to reassess what those goals are. But if you're the type of person that wants to write out all of their goals at the top of that goal list in big, bold, capital letters, write, make the rest of my life a little bit better. And this brings us to the last tip. It also may be the most important of the three. Tip number three is adopt fitness or a particular fitness activity as a part of your identity. Allow it to influence who you are, how you see yourself as a person. We all have different pursuits or activities or hobbies that really define who we are as a person. And it could be just your job, it could be your role as a family member, it could be a hobby. They form the foundation of who we are as people.
Remember when I bought my first pair of running shoes? I put them on and I was like, oh, I guess this makes me a runner now. And what does a runner do? They run. And the same thing can be applied to anything. I play music every day. I practice the craft because I identify as a musician. It's a part of who I am.
And when you take on a new activity, something that you take very seriously, something that you allow to influence who you are as a person, there's almost this feedback loop that has to happen, or else you are not who you say you are. You have to constantly be proving to yourself you are who you are by doing the things that you say you do.
I'm not saying you have to just like go out and tell everyone, I'm a fitness person now, but just start telling yourself that. You'll be surprised what happens, at least once you start believing it. My friend asked me the other day, Joe, why do you run? It seems hard, it seems stupid, it seems not fun, and you're always complaining about getting hurt. Why do you do it? And I said, I don't know. You're 100% right though. It is really dumb. And that being said, I don't really recommend it as your go-to fitness activity. It is addictive and it kind of just will consume your life. You won't want to hang out with your friends. But then later on, I thought about it. There's a lot that running gives you. Obviously, it makes you a little bit more fit.
The shoe aspect of running is pretty cool. You get to buy a lot of really expensive cutting-edge shoes. And let's not forget, when you go out for a run, you get to experience nature in all of her glory. Yeah, there's some color right there. Wow. Check out this waterfall I found, which I definitely would not have found if I was inside.
There's also a meditative side to running that is really, really pleasant. I stopped listening to music or podcasts specifically when I was running outside a long time ago. I noticed it really kind of offers a freedom of thought that I don't often get with other activities. You can just think, it's just you and your thoughts. And just someone who relies on creativity for a career, it's really, really beneficial. I think a lot of people like to think to get into running means you're probably running away from something. And I can see how people think that, and it's not entirely untrue. But I've noticed, especially just amidst the silence and your footsteps just kind of plodding away, that sometimes it feels like you're running towards something. Sometimes you really just have no choice but to think about whatever's bothering you, and you can kind of work it out in your mind. But above all, the one thing I like about running the most is, for some reason, when I'm running, I just like myself. I like who I am just a little bit more, and that's pretty powerful.